गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। So all of you can open page number 53 of your textbook, Atomic Structure and Chemical Bonding. We will start in a couple of minutes.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, everyone. So now we are going to start today the new chapter, that is Atomic Structure and Chemical Bonding. Atomic Structure. This particular atomic structure concept is combined with chemical bonding. Okay. In your earlier classes, you have also learnt about what is an atom, what an atom is made up of, okay, what are chemical bonds, what are the different types of chemical bonds. Okay. So when we are studying chemistry, what is our main objective? What we are studying in chemistry? We are interested in what type of substance? In chemistry, we are interested in matter. We want to study about matter. Okay. So, there is matter, there is energy. Okay. Energy is a closely related with matter. Okay. We focus more on the study of matter in chemistry. So from many thousands of years, humans have always wondered that what are these things made up of? Okay, we see so many physical substances around us, and person wonders what it is actually made up of. Why we are having so much diversity? Is there something basic? Everything is made up of the same thing, or there are totally different creations? What is the logic behind this? So these are some questions that since immemorial, since human civilization, people are always thinking about it, how it is possible, how these things are made up of, and so on. So one of the most oldest theories that was proposed to explain about matter, what is matter made up of, was proposed by Maharshi Kanada in 6 BC. Okay, so he gave the term that is the Paramanus, okay, Param, okay, so meaning that it is the ultimate particle, that is the smallest particle. So this concept was can be dated back all the way back to 6 BC, and after that also many other philosophers and thinkers, they have given their thoughts on how the matter is made up of. Okay, Democritus, he told the term atomos, that means something that cannot be divided, indivisible. So these kind of theories, which were not actually based on experimental evidence, were proposed way back. Okay, it is not that the grand old people were all stupid people. No, they also had an idea. They were not doing by experiments, but with their available resources and their depth of thought, they were able to come up with the hypothesis. The scientific theory that is going to propose what is matter was given by Dalton. Okay, Dalton was an English scientist, and he proposed the Dalton atomic theory. Now Dalton, based upon his own experiments and from the results from other scientists' experiments, he proposed the atomic theory. Okay, this is the first kind of a scientific theory that even today, okay, we are following. Okay, we start, whenever we discuss about matter, we start with the Dalton atomic theory. The concepts that were proposed by Dalton are true even today. Okay, but there are few exceptions or modifications to them. But you cannot say they are wrong, totally wrong. Okay, there are exceptions, there are modifications, there are new developments. The first one is, matter consists of very small and indivisible particles called atoms. Okay, so that means any matter you take, if you keep on dividing, ultimately, okay, like there was a, if you take a piece of potato and you try to keep on cutting into the smallest possible piece, okay, with the knife, whatever is person, you will reach a certain limit where you will feel that I cannot cut beyond this. Okay, in practical terms, instead of using the knife, when we are going in a laboratory setup with most sophisticated instruments, we are going at the level of molecules and atoms, we realize that this is the kind of structure, a three-dimensional structure, okay, what Dalton is visualizing. Okay, this is the model. So what Dalton is visualizing, he is visualizing a kind of a solid sphere, like a globe or something. Okay, it is a solid sphere and you cannot break it further. It is a solid iron ball or something like that. Okay, so matter is made up of very small and indivisible particles called atoms. Atoms can neither be created nor destroyed. Okay, atoms can neither be created nor destroyed. energy can be created or destroyed? Can energy?
No, sir.
Cannot be. So, in both cases, matter, can matter be created or destroyed?
No, sir.
Matter cannot be created or destroyed.
Yes. So that means, you see, the nature is like this. In a way, it is a fixed. We are in a fixed state. But there is a change. Though we are in a fixed state, there is a change. That means that net total, if you take mass, total energy of the universe, it is a constant. But there is a transformation that is taking place. The energy is getting transformed from one form to another. The matter is getting transformed from one form to another. Okay. So here atom is also the building block. That is why it is also showing the same property. It can neither be created nor destroyed. The atom of an element are alike in all respects, but they differ from the atoms of other elements. So, these two points are okay, that we are considering that atoms, okay, that is the smallest indivisible particle. That means we are telling that all matter, whether it is a water or it is an apple or whatever it may be, all are made up of atoms. Okay. And we cannot break atoms. That is fine. But what about the atoms of the water and apple when we compare? Okay. Are they going to be same, alike? When we are considering that, this particular point, what it is telling is that though they are all made up of atoms, but they are different. The atoms are different. Okay. So the atoms of different elements will be different. That means their size may be different. Okay. Their properties may be different. Okay. So the difference is there in that. But they are all made up of atoms. Atoms of an element combine in small numbers to form molecules. So what is the difference between atom and molecule?
Sir, atom is the smallest individual entity which may or may not exist independently, and molecule is a group of atoms which combine to form molecule.
Okay. So is it possible that without having a group, it will still be a molecule? That is, a single atom, can we say, is a molecule?
No, sir, a single atom is not a molecule.
Carbon. How we write carbon?
C.
Simply C, right? No? So this carbon, but when we say oxygen stable form, we write O2. Okay. This is molecule of oxygen. What is this?
An atom of carbon.
Can I say a molecule of carbon?
No.
Yes, sir.
Why not?
Sir. But how, sir?
So here we have to understand there are differences, fine difference. When you talk about atom, when you talk about molecule, first and most important point in chemistry, what is the purpose of the existence of any reaction of any atom or molecule, whatever is there? There is only one purpose, that is stability. Whatever elements are there in the nature, they are all want to be stable. Okay, ultimately they want to be stable, and that is why they are reacting. They are reacting to get rid of that excess energy and become stable. Now, a molecule is stable or atom is stable?
Molecule
is stable. Without exception, whenever you are using the word molecule, that means stable. Atom. An atom may or may not be stable. For example, here you are seeing carbon. Okay. Fluorine. Okay. Like this. Monoatomic. These are all monoatomic, no? So when you can say these are monoatomic molecules, monoatomic, this is a diatomic. So these are stable in their own form. They are stable. Carbon is stable by itself, pure carbon. Okay, diamond is stable or not? People are happy, it is stable, otherwise they will not buy. Okay, so a molecule is always stable. An atom may or may not be stable. The atoms of an element will combine in small numbers to form molecules. Okay, because the atoms may or may not be stable. If they are unstable kind of atoms, then to become stable, they will combine with the other atoms. Okay, and they will form the molecules. That is what number 4 postulate is saying. Next, atoms of one element combine with atoms of another element in a simple ratio to form molecules of compounds. So here we are seeing that introduction of the terms. Okay, very nice postulate how he has made it. So first, starting with matter. Okay, from matter you are coming to the building blocks, that is the atoms. From atoms you are coming to molecules, how the molecules are formed, and from molecules you are coming to compounds. So a compound, can I say this O2 is a compound or not?
No sir, O2 is an element.
No sir, it's a molecule.
Molecule. It's a molecule. Why I cannot say it is a compound?
Sir, because compound is a mixture of two or more elements.
Different elements.
Yes sir.
So if it is made up of same element, for example O2 is oxygen bounded to oxygen, both are just same element is bound to each other. In such a case, what is going to happen?
They will become molecules.
So they will form a molecule of oxygen.
Okay, but for example it is carbon monoxide. Okay, CO, carbon monoxide. So this one is a
compound.
So can I say that I have a few molecules of the compound? Are the compounds made up of molecules?
Yes, sir.
Molecule means it is stable. Compound, if the compound what is being formed is a stable compound, then we can say that whatever that individual substance is there, okay, that is a molecule of the compound. So here what you are telling, atoms of one element combine with atoms of another element in a simple ratio to form molecules of the compounds. Very clean and very straightforward, very nice postulate. Okay, first we saw what is atom, we saw what is a molecule, and then now we are seeing that atoms of different elements, okay, here another element is a different element, they will combine in a simple ratio to form the molecules of the compounds. Next, atoms are the smallest unit of matter that can take part in a chemical reaction. Smallest unit of matter that can take part in a chemical reaction means what? Atoms are going to be reactive. They are the ones that will react. Okay, so that means we are not just telling that matter consists of very small indivisible particles called atoms. Okay, over. No. What is the property of that atom? It is a unit of matter. Okay, it is the smallest particle, that is also correct, but it will participate in the chemical reaction. Each atom is capable of individually, you can pick up one atom and you can make it to react. Okay, it is not important that you should have 100 atoms of the molecule of the element react. No, that's not required. One atom is quite sufficient, capable of making the reaction. Okay, so atoms are the smallest unit of matter that can take part in a chemical reaction. Okay, so you have followed atomic postulates by Dalton. Any doubts you have in this one?
No, sir.
Okay, so here one thing you have sir, to keep in mind. Yes,
sir, I have a doubt. Sir, can you give one example in which atoms are reacting with each other?
Atoms are reacting.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, stable and unstable atom. Okay. So, when we will be seeing periodic table, okay, then we will learn more about the reactivity. Then you will see in periodic table, elements are there towards the extreme left and extreme right of the periodic table. For example, sodium Na, potassium K. These ones are so highly reactive. Okay, it is a very favorite experiment. Teachers will demonstrate to the student. They will bring a small piece of sodium metal, okay, one beaker of water, and just put that small piece in the water. Immediately there will be an explosive reaction. So all the children will open their mouths wide open. What happened? Okay, until now it was all okay, fine. What happened? Suddenly put in water and so much gases and fumes and light, everything is coming. Okay, very reactive. So sodium is so unstable, you have to put under kerosene. If you keep normal air also, it will react with the moisture in the air and it will be converted to the compound sodium hydroxide. Okay, you have heard about sodium hydroxide. You know what is sodium hydroxide. So sodium, here sodium is a, you can consider one atom of sodium is the smallest particle of that matter that is capable of participating in the chemical reaction. It is unstable. Okay, so when we talk about stable and unstable, the most stable elements are what we say inert gases, group number 18, you will see in the periodic table. Please always, whenever you get time in chemistry, you should always look at the periodic table. What are the elements? You have to revise that. It's very important. Okay, periodic table is going to be very important. People are coming to class 10 and they don't know properly what is the element, what is the then it becomes very difficult. Okay, class 9 is the platform for you to build your basics for class 10. Okay, that's why you have to be good in your basics. Okay, this is one example. It answers your question.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, we'll move to the proper definition. That is an element. An element is a pure substance that can neither be formed from nor decomposed into simple substances by ordinary physical or chemical methods. Okay, what it means? An element is a pure substance. That means it won't have any mixture of other elements. It's a pure, only one type of matter is there. And it can neither be formed from nor decomposed into simple substances. So here also what the concept is coming, can neither be created nor destroyed. That same concept is coming here in the element also. In atom also same concept is coming, in element also same concept, neither be formed from nor decomposed into simple substances by ordinary physical or chemical methods. So if you take for example oxygen is an element. Okay, there are number of elements are there in the periodic table. Whatever elements have been identified so far, okay, most of them have been placed in the periodic table, grouped in the periodic table, classified and put in the periodic table. So the element is a pure substance. When you say oxygen, it means you will have only the atoms of oxygen, not any other element. And you cannot create oxygen. You cannot decompose this oxygen, break down this oxygen into any simpler substances, into any other element by ordinary physical and chemical methods. Okay, this part you understood?
Yes,
sir. Now,
yes, sir.
Now, in a nuclear reaction, okay, here this is ordinary physical and chemical method. We have to write that. Why? Because there are also nuclear reactions. In a nuclear reaction, what happens is new elements can come from existing element. Uranium-235, okay, making atom bombs or using that for the nuclear reactor to make the energy. From that heavy atom, you are getting the different elements. That means you are able to create new elements from an existing element. It is a decomposing to form the other elements. Okay, it is possible. But how it is possible? By nuclear reaction it is possible. It is not possible by ordinary physical or chemical methods. So that has to be mentioned in the definition of an element. Next, atom is the smallest particle element that exhibits all the properties of that element. It may or may not exist independently, but it will take part in every chemical reaction. So what it means, may or may not exist independently?
So it means it may be stable or not stable.
Yes, correct. May or may not be stable. Okay. So smallest particle of an element that exhibits all the properties of that element, it may be stable or unstable, but it will take part in every chemical reaction. So you can define this in this way, atom. Okay. Next. So far, we are understanding that the atom has these properties. Dalton told that we cannot break it down. It is the smallest particle of matter. So this is the model of Dalton. Immediately when you talk about Dalton, Dalton's model of atom, this solid sphere should come to your mind, because there are other models we will see describing the structure of the atom. This is the first structure, solid ball. The turning point came with the discovery of electrons. In your class 8, you have studied about electrons, you have studied about some basic idea how the electrons were discovered, what cathode rays, okay, basic things you have understood. So there is more detail in this particular in class 9, okay. Specifically how these discoveries were made, they are given in a sequence, okay. One thing that you have to keep in mind is these are all old models. We are not going to follow these models. So in a way we are studying history in chemistry. Okay. How far it is useful to you? So much of history and all. Okay. This is for you to understand how the science progressed, how these things have evolved. Okay, that is why it is given in your book, it is given in your syllabus, and we should know about it, how the discovery was made, what is the scientific basis. The discovery of electrons. So gases, whether they are good conductor of electricity?
No, sir, bad conductor.
So if the gas was a good conductor of electricity, then we don't have to use electrical wires. Simply the current would pass through the air, and that could be a dangerous situation also. So there was some experiments that were being done at that time, because the scientists were very interested in the lightning. Okay, the thunders, what you see in the sky. So they observed that the gases can become good conductors of electricity when a high voltage, more than 10,000 volts, was applied, and it should be at a low pressure, that is 0.01 mmHg, 0.01 atmospheres or something like that, 0.01 mmHg of pressure, less than that. So what happens when we go in the atmosphere, when we are going at the higher altitudes, what happens to the pressure?
Decreases.
So when you are going high in the atmosphere, pressure is decreasing. And this clouds, they have huge number of water molecules, dust molecules, they are there inside them. And they have a lot of static charge. Okay, charge, they have static charge. So there is a certain phenomena wherein they are colliding, and that is sufficient to create a very large voltage, and the pressure is also low. And under these conditions, the gases will become good conductors of electricity. The same concept is being applied here in the laboratory setting. Okay, in a laboratory, this kind of tube was designed for the discovery of electron. Okay. So we will discuss about the discovery of the electron in the next class. I will take your attendance. If you have any doubt, you can ask.